Hello everyone, hope you are all doing well and you must have missed the IT videos. So we are again back with the videos of IT after a long break from the IT videos. We had actually started making physical education videos, but now we are back on the IT videos also. So today we are going to discuss solutions of chapter networking and internet, and with this video our chapter networking and internet will be over and you can prepare it well from the videos. So as we are going to discuss the exercises and their solutions, so before that I would like to give you a suggestion that whenever you are attempting question and answers after reading the chapter, so you must try to give the answer before knowing the original answer, so that you are aware of how much you have understood the chapter. So make sure that you answer the question before I display the answer. So first is, give the full form of ARPANET, Advanced Research Projects Agency Network. LAN, very simple, Local Area Network. MAN, Metropolitan Area Network. WAN, Wide Area Network. WWW, World Wide Web. And Telnet, maybe some of you have forgotten this, but it is Terminal Network. Now, question number 2 is, differentiate between the following. There are 8 parts and we have read about each of them. We have studied about the topologies. We have also studied the various networks, LAN, MAN and WAN, and also the Internet and World Wide Web. So I think you must not face any problem in these, because these topics we have already discussed in detail in the videos. Now, our next question is, what is the purpose of network devices? And we have to explain these network devices also. So, we have already discussed about the purpose and the various network devices required for network. So, what is the purpose? We require the network devices for communication and interaction between devices on a computer network. They mediate data transmission in a computer network. Basically, we have already covered this chapter in 4 parts, and you can refer to the previous videos for more understanding of the chapter. Now, in this question, we have to list that which acts are cyber crimes. So basically, cyber crime and normal crimes such as theft, robbery, kidnapping, etc. These are normal crimes, and cyber crime is something related to computer, internet, stealing someone's data from computer. These all are something counted under cyber crime. So crime and cyber crime are two different things, and we need not mix them. So here we have to identify which are cyber crimes. So first is, copying data from someone's computer without his permission. Of course, here we are stealing someone's data from someone's computer even without permission. So of course, it is a cybercrime. Next is stealing someone's device. So as I have mentioned in the starting only that cybercrime is something related to internet and computer. Here it is not specifically mentioned that it is the devices of computer or it is any data which we are stealing from someone's computer. So we cannot specify that it is a cybercrime. It is a normal crime which will be counted as stealing. So it is a normal crime, not a cybercrime. Next is accessing one's account for carrying online transactions. Here in this statement, it is not specified that we are carrying that online transaction with the permission of that person or without his permission. So, of course, it depends upon the situation if we are doing the transaction with the permission of that person. So, it is not illegal. It is not a cybercrime. But of course, if we are doing the online transaction without his permission, then of course it is a cybercrime. Next is modifying the official documents without permission. Here also you might be confused and you might declare it as a cybercrime, but actually here it is only written that official documents. It is not written that those official documents are present in the computer, in any software in the form of data. So the official documents may be on simple paper, they may be hard copy, and we may not declare it as a cyber crime. Next is creating a fake identity and posting on someone's behalf. Of course, reading the statement, you might think of it as hacking, and of course it is a type of hacking. If we are creating fake identity on behalf of someone and then posting it, so it is a kind of hacking, and we know that hacking is a cyber crime. Next is sending friend request to someone on a social networking site. Of course, this is not a cyber crime and this is not even a crime. If we are simply sending someone friend request on a social networking site, then it is not a crime and not even cybercrime. It will not be counted under any kind of crime. Now, our next question is, what are cookies? Basically, if it is asked in one mark, then you can just simply write that it is a small piece of information about the client browsing a website. And if it is a long question, then of course you have to mention it in detail, and it's the common condition for all questions. If you are asked for one mark question, then you have to give a short answer in one or two lines. And if you are asked a 3 or 5 marks question, then of course you need to give the details of the answers too. So here, if you are just asked about one mark question, so you can simply answer in one line, whereas if it is a long question, so you must give the details properly. Our next question is, differentiate between firewall and antivirus and how both contribute to the security of the system. Firewall and antivirus, we have already discussed about these topics in the video of chapter networking and internet. Basically, both are used for security of the system, and here in the table you are given the main difference between antivirus and firewall. So we need not explain it again as we have discussed it in the video. And the next part of the question says how both of these contribute to the security of the system. So here is how firewall and antivirus protects our system and its security. For more details of the answer, you can visit to the video. Our next question is, define protocol. So basically here it is not mentioned about any specific protocol. So what is basically the protocol? Protocol is a set of rules. But if we are specifically talking about a specific protocol, then of course we need to mention about it. So as we are reading the chapter Networking and Internet, so we will answer to according to this chapter. So what is network protocol? It defines the rules and conventions of communication that must be followed when two devices interact with each other. Our next question is, explain TCP/IP model. As you know, I have discussed and explained all the topics in the video, so I am not explaining the topics again. That will be simply a wastage of time. So you have to note the key points from the TCP/IP model. If you have any problem in the question, you can also refer to our video of chapter Networking and Internet. As the question is asking about the TCP/IP model, so of course we will mention the layers of the TCP/IP model, which are link layer, internet layer, transport layer and application layer. Now our next question is, what is the significance of cyber law? So as I have already told you that whichever question is there, you have to answer according to the marks. So according to the requirement of the marks, you are going to answer the question, and here we have explained all the details of the question. Now our next question is, how is Telnet used for remote login? We have discussed about Telnet, the terminal networking, and now here is it is asking that how it is used for remote login. So we have to mention the steps basically. So as we have discussed, we are not going to discuss again. You can just note it down. Now our next question is, what is the difference between email and chat? So basically these two terms are different and we should not mix up their meanings. These are both different terms. Here in the table it is given the difference between email and chat. So from the table we can conclude that email is not a real-time conversation and it is a formal type of communication, whereas chat, it is a real-time conversation and it is generally an informal communication. Now our next question, question number 12, is to list the various security issues concerned with using the internet. So basically we have to list the security issues that are concerned with internet, and also we have to explain them giving examples. So first is malware. Now our next question, question number 13, is list various protective measures that can be taken for network security. So as we have discussed in the chapter about some protective measures for network security, so here we are going to list them. First is network layer security, second is firewalls, third is antivirus, password managers, and cyber law. Basically in such type of questions you should also give the detail of each point so that the answer is properly clear. Now our second last question is, define cyber crime and cyber law. We have already defined the cyber law in previous question. Here we will define both, and as we are asked only to define cybercrime and cyber law, so we need not give more detail about each, like what are the different cybercrime. We have to define each cybercrime. If it is mentioned, then only you will define them, otherwise there is no specific need of mentioning each cybercrime in detail. You can just give the definition of cybercrime and cyber law, and that is sufficient. Define digital literacy. Last question of the exercise. As it was a separate topic of the chapter, so I hope you have no problem in understanding this topic. If you are asked in one mark question, then of course you can simply give the definition of digital literacy. And if it is a long question, then you need to mention its points too. Also, it is not necessary that you mention the answer in points. You can also mention it paragraph wise, but sometimes points are more clear than the paragraph. It depends upon the question. With this video, our chapter Networking and Internet is over. So, more videos of IT will be coming soon. Till then, keep supporting. Bye-bye.